Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker is set to be a film by writer and director J.J. Abrams that will not only have a lot of emotional moments in this movie, but also a lot of unexpected sequences for the characters of Kylo Ren and Rey in this story. This is Mike Zero. If you guys are new to the channel, do make sure to subscribe to see future Star Wars content. Now, one great thing about this film is that we do know that J.J. Abrams is taking both Rey and Kylo Ren in a certain direction that we have never seen before in the Skywalker saga, which really is going to be a very interesting story that will be told by both JJ and Chris, and exactly how they are going to utilize these characters in the same exact environment with each other. Now, these past couple of weeks or so, we've been learning a whole lot more about this film, and when it all comes down to one of the concept art descriptions, this is where things begin to get a little intriguing, involving the dark energy that is going to be a part of this film, the new foe, and the relationship between both Rey and Kylo Ren. Now, specifically, a description of Rey meditating on a boulder in a crystal cave that gives off a blue hue, where it's described that she is interrupted by Kylo's voice, where it's said that she turns around witnessing Kylo in the cave. This is when Rey decides to pause her training and walks close to Kylo. This is said to be the scene in which Kylo asks Rey if she has felt it, and this is in reference to the new foe in the film. The next goes over Kylo and Rey holding hands and sitting on the ground in the cave, where the sequence is described to be an emotional piece that continues the relationship between Kylo and Rey and how it begins to evolve and change in the story. It's said to be that Rey begins to shed a tear for an unknown reason, where Kylo is said to wipe the tear off from her cheek, where Rey opens her eyes and looks into Kylo's eyes, where it's described that she feels a shift from Kylo returning to Ben Solo, only for the bond to be interrupted from an unknown reason, where Kylo and Rey are cut from a dark side energy from afar. So I really want to go over a couple of parts about this. Now, first things first, we do know that J.J. Abrams is continuing the concept of Force bonds that were introduced in The Last Jedi by director Rian Johnson. Now, I feel like it was a little overused in Episode 8, and I hope that's not going to be the case in Episode 9. I hope that they really do keep this on a minimal level where the Force bonds are being used, because we are also getting this embedded within the lightsaber duel, which honestly, guys, I don't mind. I love the idea of flash fights. But I just hope that we do get a lot more scenes, you know, in comparison to the scenes that we got in The Last Jedi between both Rey and Kylo Ren, where they're actually physically near each other. So this particular sequence, without a doubt, picks up on the whole idea of Reylo, you know, the relationship between both Rey and Kylo Ren, and exactly where that's going in this story. We do know that the ending of Episode 9 is going to be based off of a couple of the Disney animated movies from the 1990s, and there's a good chance that one of the endings is going to be Beauty and the Beast, and that is actually going to be the source material for inspiration to end the Skywalker saga. A lot of people are thinking that that has to do with Kylo Ren and Rey. Now, this particular sequence, though, what's really intriguing to me is that Kylo Ren actually interrupts Rey's meditation session inside of this crystal cave, where they begin to actually have this bond again, where it leads to a sequence in which it becomes an emotional scene, where Rey begins to shed a tear or two for some reason, we're not quite sure why, where Kylo Ren then wipes the tear off of Rey's cheek. And this, without a doubt, is going to be a very emotional moment on the big screen. You can already see what JJ is trying to do between these two characters. Now, not only that, all right, this is the moment in which Kylo Ren asks Rey if she has felt it, and he's actually referencing the dark side energy that Kylo has been feeling that's making him feel vulnerable in this movie, and Rey actually does feel as well, as we have gone over before in the past. So this is, of course, in reference to the new villain, right? The new foe that is going to be very significant in the third act of the movie and is going to engage in a lightsaber duel with both Kylo Ren and Rey. Now, not only that, what really does intrigue me the most about all of this is the moment in which Rey begins to feel a shift within Kylo Ren. But this dark acolyte is in the movie and is going to have a major influence on Rey and Kylo Ren. And this character, all right, this dark side energy interrupts the force bond between both Rey and Kylo. Just as Kylo is beginning to shift back to Ben Solo, she sees it in his eyes as she is looking into his eyes. So you can really see what they're trying to do here. They're really kind of taking a lot of source material from Star Wars Legends as well. We've seen great examples just like this in Legends. I'm sure that a lot of you guys who are very well educated on the expanded universe know exactly what I'm talking about. You know, the whole entire idea with Jason Solo and stuff like that. But when we think about Episode 9, We do know that JJ and Chris are using a lot of Legends material in order to advance the relationship between both Rey and Kylo, and exactly where that's going to go in episode 9 and the actual ending of the movie itself. So this particular Force Bond sequence, guys, I have to say, through the mention of, you know, this dark side energy, this dark energy from afar being sensed by both Kylo and Rey, and how it is actually responsible for interrupting the Force Bond between both Rey and Kylo Ren, it really brings one to question exactly, you know, who really is in charge of the Force Bonds and how they really work. You know, could it really have been connected by somebody other than Snoke, for all we know, keeping that intact? You know, there's a lot of things going on with this movie that I think are going to go in multiple different directions that's really going to change the Star Wars lore when it all comes down to Rey and Kylo Ren. Anyways, guys, drop a comment below. Let me know what you think about all of this in the comments. And if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you all so very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.